This is I Need More Cowbell, and it is July 18th, 2016. 16th. And on Thursday, my grandmother passed away. She wasn't eating. She wasn't drinking any water. She didn't want to. If she did eat, it would be a spoonful or two of applesauce. What really gets me is because of her Alzheimer's and dementia, she had no complete idea about what's going on. And so she didn't know why she was hurting. She didn't know what was wrong with her leg, you know, because she broke her hip. Whether or not she felt or somebody pushed her is another story. Those people, we don't know. They could have been, you know, those people there at the care facility. They weren't too fond of her because she was a little aggressive, a little feisty. But she, like I said, she was in pain. And whenever the nurses would come and check on her at the hospice, she would fight them. And she would be violent. She'd be violent and feisty with them. So they would put her back to sleep. And it just was a continuous cycle until she finally passed away. So it's been a few days. So I'm okay to a degree now. I miss my grandmother, but I'm sad. I am sad. But I don't know. My uncle was going to do an investigation about it, but all my grandmother's kids came together and just agreed to let her rest finally, to let her to move on with the procedures and ceremonies and so on, and do what the family's gonna do. She wanted to be cremated. She wanted to be cremated, so they're gonna do that. And did you know it costs like $2,000 to cremate somebody? Can you believe that? That's a lot of money. I mean, what? It's like a industrial size furnace. They burn you. They burn you straight down to the bones, and the only thing that's really in the cremation, you know, the ashes are. I'm just getting some high levels here. Jeez. The only what your ashes are at the end is the bones. There's no. It's not your arm. It's not your muscles. It's not your eyeballs. It's not that intelligent brain of yours. Because it just burns away, like cooking a pig too long. So it's $2,000 plus, and they're gonna get in that. You know, all the kids are gonna pay towards that, and like $300 per person per child of my grandmother. And then the children of the children, like me, $20 or so, everybody kicks in for food. For the party. You gotta have a party for the passing of your loved ones. And it's gonna be here at my house. This house has always just been like it's an old house, but it's only me and my mother here right now, so we're not inconveniencing anybody. It's a sizable house. I mean, it was for a larger family when I was younger, but there's a pool. You know, kids like to swim in the pool. We're kind of far. I don't know. not to some, but but yeah, you know what, when my mom called me, she told me at like 4:30, and I was about ready to go to work, and I just kind of sat there, and I was like, should I go into work? Should I go in, or should I call out? I should call out, right? I mean, I called out when she was moved to the hospice, and I go, is it all right if I call out again? It's that I'm delivering pizza. I'll call out as many times as I want. So I did. I called and I said, hey, I'm not coming in. I mean, they already knew that I was, that something was going to happen eventually, because I called out on Sunday and then I don't work Monday, Tuesday, or Wednesday. So I don't work there anyways, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. And you know, so I called in on Thursday. I just called out. And luckily, it was Amanda, the lady manager. And I don't know if it's just because she's, like I said, she follows the rules, which is why I like her more than the other managers. But what the hell is that noise out there? Oh, garbage truck. I wonder if it even picks up in the microphone, because I can hear it. But she's easier to talk to than the other guys. Like the guy managers don't seem to care about Amanda. I mean, there's other lady managers there, and I don't ever talk to them at all. But I think it's just because Amanda's mean, it's easier to talk to her. So when I called in the store, you know, one of the girls answered, and they're gonna put me on hold. And I said, hey, hold on there, I'm a driver. Can I talk to one of the managers? So I talked to Amanda, answered the phone, and I talked to her, and she said, okay, just let us know when anything is going on in the future, and you know, we'll see you when you come in. And I went in on Friday. Nobody expected me to, but you know, what else was I gonna do? Just sit around, sad. But so I went, you know, I took a shower and I went to the hospice, and you know, the parking lot was already full of family. And so, you know, right when I get there, my sister and her daughter get there too. And I got to play this part back just see if I can actually hear the garbage trucks. Yeah, my sister and niece got there, and then my aunt also got there too. So we all got there kind of, you know, same. I'm babbling here. We got there, we got inside, and my mom was in the hallway with my aunt, the eldest, and it was basically my mom, my aunt, and my cousin, and they were the ones who were, you know, really taking care of my Nana and the aunt, you know, for the last couple of years. You know, they were the ones who were in charge of finding a place for her to stay, and getting her paperwork in order and everything. They were the ones that were taking care of everything, just because they knew what to do. So they were discussing on what to do, and you know, now, next. And some people didn't realize that my grandmother wanted to be cremated. Some people didn't realize that she had a do not resuscitate on her will. So, you know, so we get there, and all my family's in like this hall, this open room, and so I, you know, I go and I hug everybody, and then I go into my my grandmother's room, and you know, there she was. I removed a lot of stuff. So I was there for like 6 hours. In my grandmother's room, with my family. My family would rotate in and out, between cousins and aunts and uncles. You know, not everybody came, but a lot of people came. And that's fine. I know some people couldn't make it. Some people were too far. And about 9 o'clock, you know, most of the people already left, and it was just me, my mother, my sister and her daughter, and my uncle, and then eventually another cousin came, cousin from the eldest brother. I forget that my Uncle Benny's older than my Auntie Linda. Anyway, so about that time, you know, we were all pretty hungry, so my sister volunteered to go out and get taquitos. And a taquito, in case you don't know, is a corn tortilla rolled up. Excuse me. Corn tortilla rolled up, and it has like steak or beef or chicken. If it's beef, it's shredded beef. None of that ground shit. That doesn't taste right. Anyways, and then it's like fried, and then it's just smothered in cheese. And then also maybe some pico de gallo, you know, some tomatoes, some onions, some cilantro, then sour cream and guacamole also, and some, maybe some salsa, whatever. You know, there's all kinds of ways to do it, but it's basically, it's a little rolled tortilla, taquito. You know, like paquito is little. So, if that's right. So she came back and, you know, she gave me a pack of 12, and her and my mother split a pack of 12. And my niece got a quesadilla because she doesn't eat anything. So there we are eating dinner with my grandmother one last time. And it was weird, you know. I knew it was a little odd, but because, I mean, she's gone. And she's still in the room, and this is really like the first family member I've been around for an extended period of time after they passed. My grandfather passed away, my dad's dad passed away, but he was in another state, so I never really saw that end result. You know, I saw when he was alive, and I saw him when he was alive, and then I saw him at his funeral. There's like 2 weeks in between. When we left, it was kind of strange because, like, no nurse went in afterwards, you know, after they declared she's gone. No nurse came in later on. And what was even weirder is, in another room, just a little down the hallway, a man passed away also, 2 hours later from my grandmother. And the family came, and it was like four people. And then, shortly after, they, you know, they moved him out. They cleared his room, and he went to his new lodgings, but my grandmother was still there. And they said the examiner, if they doesn't get to her tonight, which he didn't, they'll get to her in the morning. And what they'll do is they'll put the AC down, which, you know, put it down to 50. I'm not sure what it's supposed to go down to, but that's what we put it down to when we left. I had to edit a lot of stuff out. We don't know. I don't know yet when she's gonna get cremated. I don't know when we're gonna have the ceremony at the church. I do know that she's gonna be with us for a while. She wanted her ashes to be thrown at South Mountain here, and it's funny, as a native to Arizona, I don't know what these damn mountains are named, so I just am going to assume when I look south, it's going to be one of those mountain ranges. And she didn't want to be flung out when it was hot. She wanted to wait till when it was cold. So we're going to hold on to her for a while. All the family wanted like a vial of her ashes. And that's, I don't know. I have... Ashes are weird, man. I don't know. So I don't really want to separate somebody unless you throw them all. It's like you either have all of the person or you have none of the person. Keeping a small amount of the person and separating it just seems a little torturous. I don't know. It doesn't seem right. But I guess that's what the family wants. Me, I'd like to be at the end of the night when we were done eating our disappointing tequilas. They're disappointing because they did not put the guacamole. They said they were gonna put it on the side, and there wasn't any at all. So those taquitos were really dry. So it got to a point at the end of the night before we left where we're discussing what we would do with, the bodies of our family. I heard earlier in the day that my aunt said that she's going to get cremated too. And then I know my sister said she doesn't care. When she's dead, she doesn't care what happens with her body, which is a pain in the butt. Because, like, well, what am I supposed to do with it, you know? If my mom said something, I didn't hear her. Or I just don't remember. But I asked my niece, I go, what do you want me to do with your body? And she goes, what? I go, look, I got another 80 years with you. I go, what do you want me to do with your body? Because the joke is I'll always outlive her. And I know I will. So, and she didn't really have an answer. So I was like, you want me to take you skydiving? And she goes, what? I go, yeah, just take you skydiving over the, the Pacific Ocean. And before I get too low, I just release you while I open my parachute at the same time. So she just falls into the water, never to be seen again. I think that would be a valid way to go. I mean, what else am I going to do with the body? Bury it? I told my buddy, he wanted me to make him into bullets for the zombie apocalypse. So if he dies, burn him down and then fuse him into some bullets. And then I said, you know what? What I'll do with some of the rest of it is I'll make a little statue that resembles him out of his ashes compressed, and then I'll make like compressed snowflakes, and I'll make a snow globe out of him. Keep it on my mantle. His wife wasn't too happy about that idea. So, with that long, it's 38 minutes right now. I spent like 20 minutes trying to talk about this, and I had to recompose myself a couple of times there. A couple times. Anyways, so speaking of great, exciting things, I'm sure I'll mention when we have my grandmother's funeral. But this week is to painfully move on. And this podcast this week is Sonic's 25th anniversary party in California. It's also San Diego Comic-Con, and I'm not going to any of it. I just could not manage to make that money up. I cannot afford the trip. And at least the ticket was only $25, but I tried. Not as well as I could have, but at least bought the ticket, so there's one less person there. One less person that gets to go. That sucks. I mean, how long did I have? Like 2 months, right? 2 months to do something? 2-3 months? I don't know. I'm not fucking happy about that at all. I don't want to go to work. I don't want to go to work this weekend, especially if that thing's going on. I don't want to sit and watch it. I don't want to sit and watch the damn thing either, but whatever. Okay, so, I didn't get the damn things this week. What did I do the last couple of days? You know what I did? You know what I tried to do? Now, I made a review for, not a review, but I did an unboxing for my LG G5. And I showed off this nice little lock screen animation that happens. You know, you open, you turn on the phone, you double tap or whatever, you push the button in the back, and the phone goes to the lock screen, and it's a nice little video, and it looks really nice. And I started thinking, I was like, you know what, I want my blazing cowbell spinning on that thing. So I started looking and looking and looking, and I spent like 4 days, 5 days trying to find this out. I spent all weekend trying to look for it. I'm going through all kinds of tutorials. I'm going through all kinds of videos and forum posts and whatever, and I posted onto Reddit. You know, I'm asking people, how the fuck do you do this? How do you make a live wallpaper, but it plays like once? It's only like 5 seconds long, and even if that, and it's on the lock screen, because there's live wallpapers, and it appears for the background, and it appears for the lock screen, but the lock screen live wallpapers do not show up for the background wallpapers for the home screen. So I'm like, what the hell? And I got a live wallpaper of the blazing cowbell that's spinning around in the back of the montage. It looks okay, but it could be better. It doesn't fit right. It's distracting. That's what I don't like about live wallpapers. They're distracting. That's why I liked it for the lock screen. And I had like all these ideas, like of different things that I like to make as live wallpapers. You know, I can do some Sonic stuff. I can do some Halo things. You know, some Adventure Time. You know, all kinds of like, all it has to be is like a 5 minute video, like a 5 second video at most. You know, Finn doing his eyebrows. In case you don't know, all those eyebrow gifs on the internet, gifs, gifs, memes, things, Giphy cats, actually are mine. If you see a weird signature in the bottom right, that's mine. You know what? I really should do that. I've been meaning to do this one eyebrow montage of just like everybody's. Because I started making, I was editing episodes to make my own. Because there's a simple Finn and Flame Princess one. And I extended it to the full 3 sets, just like Marceline and Ice King. But I gotta get to it. Anyways, a future project. Future project from like 4 years ago, right? So, I'm just fucking mumbling on over here. Wanted to do a live wallpaper and for the lock screen, and I couldn't do it. And finally this morning, I find out that the reason is, I find out because somebody took the files out from the phone and decompiled the specific thing, that yellow kaleidoscope, and he said it's an MP4 file is what's inside of it. It's an MP4 file, and that's it. So he made a test and put his own little file in there, and it wouldn't work because it's like a specific signature key on the file, and it only recognizes these two. The kaleidoscope, the yellow kaleidoscope flower thing, and that stupid cat. The stupid friend cat. And so, so I can't do it. There is no way to make my own lock screen live wallpaper for my phone. I can make a live wallpaper for the background, but I don't really care about that. I mean, I guess I could, but do I really want to? Like I said, they're too busy. They get distracting. I like a nice static image in the back, but I'll keep it in mind. I was just pissed, I tried to make stickers, but last week, the week before, and I couldn't do that. It's stickers and t-shirts, because that person just didn't know what the fuck, I should have just called up the boss, been like, hey, I know how to do this stuff. But he's probably fucking that girl, so whatever. And she's like, this old guy just needed a girl, and she's like, well, I need a job, and he's like, okay, but you know how to do this stuff? She's like, nope, but I know how to suck deek. That's the way business works, right? So I couldn't get stickers. I couldn't get t-shirts. Can't make a damn live wallpaper for my lock screen. Just gotta keep moving forward, right? That's all I can do. Oh, man. Let's see here. What else? So I get back to work on Friday. I mean, like I said, I went to work on Friday. Nobody expected me to be there. And I didn't feel like going there. And then I went to work on Saturday. I really didn't want to be there on Saturday. And then I went to work on Sunday, and I don't want to be there at all. I don't want to be to work all weekend. It just sucked, you know. Driving around, and then my AC doesn't work. I think I'm having battery issues or something with my car. It cranks, but it doesn't start. So I don't know. The starter's fine, so maybe it's the ignition. But my friend said it might be the battery. And if it's a battery, I can kind of understand. Maybe it's just too damn hot for my battery is what it happens, you know. My hood's black. It's a carbon fiber hood. But it doesn't have any clear coat on it, so it's not really reflecting any of the heat, the sunlight. It's just like getting absorbed right into the carbon fiber and the underlining fiberglass. I say the battery too, because my phone is having a hell of a time with the heat. When I'm outside, my phone gets hot real fast, and that percentage goes down real bad. I mean, by the time I got home from work on Saturday, I actually hit like 13%, and I've never been that low from work, so hopefully, no, I'll take the battery out and get it checked out tomorrow, and they're going to be like, oh, the battery's fine, or they're going to be like, oh, you're going to need a new battery, and it's like, hey, it's under warranty, you get me a new battery, and you get it with a smile. I don't know. That's pretty much all I really got to say. I'm looking at, well, like maybe 25 minutes or something, because I spent 20 minutes crying. One of the things I wanted to do is, at the 405th, the 405th, it's for Star Wars cosplay, right? It's for stormtroopers, and and they have a section there for Halo Spartan armor. So one young man, he managed to get all the armors from the Halo Waypoint website, because you can change your armor, you can customize your Spartan armor there, and the emblem, I believe, right? Customize the armor in colors at least. And so he ripped all the armors somehow from the website. And so now I have all the armors. And I was like, well, I always wanted my own Spartan armor, so I was gonna make it for Comic-Con, if I mentioned that at all back then. And so I was looking at, he was like, I like my Anubis set and I like my Legionnaire helmet, so that's what I was gonna do. But then we got Achilles. I was like, I like Achilles, but I miss my wings on my Anubis set. So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna remodel this model here, and I'm gonna merge the two together. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna try this week. Gonna merge the two armor sets together, and then I'm gonna use substance painter, right? I believe that's what it's called, and paint the textures on. Make it look nice. I think what really looks nice about the Achilles armor is because of the shiny metal that's there. You know, you got the chrome, right? I think that's what looks nice about it. So I'm gonna like merge the accents, the chrome accents, with the Anubis set and some like angles and stuff like that. I think it'll look nice. But yeah, I think that's it. I don't. Aside from my grandmother, and not going to Sonic, not going to the Sonic anniversary, and my car died. I didn't really have nothing to say. I did somehow manage to skip this part right here, though, which is I'm gonna say maybe Tuesday, Wednesday, I'll have a montage up, a little montage of myself. You know, I got so many clips from Halo 5 that I've just saved, and I haven't done nothing with. I've used some for you know, the last two montages for the company, but I haven't used any for myself. So I'm gonna start getting those together. Maybe I'll just have them all ready and just put one up every couple days. Just so the only thing on YouTube isn't these audio clips. Because, you know, nobody's listening to them anyways. So I could even have the 20 minutes of me crying over my grandmother and nobody would notice. Not for years anyways. But yeah. With that, I think I'm done. I'm done for today. Done for the podcast, and it's about 11 o'clock, so I gotta get ready for Twitch, because I gotta start doing that. Gotta do the Twitch, gotta keep up with the Twitch. I don't know what I'm gonna play. I don't really want to play Halo for Twitch. Go back to Shadows of Mordor, maybe. Maybe I'll redo the graphics for my page. Post up in the creatives area of Twitch. I don't know. We'll see how it is. So that's it for this week. Obviously very short. Not much to say. That's alright. Take care of yourselves. Have a good one. I'll talk to you next week. Jeez, did you hear my shoulder pop?
Sure, I don't want any credit for anything.
No,
fuck. Just because I'm
voting on them with an own house.
And I flipped all of them. I flipped them. Damn, and they got it.
Hey, you guys can do it without me.
Night takedown.
Yay.
Level 8 wrecks available. Round complete.
Cowbell.
What? Chain gun or Gauss?
Chain gun.
Alright, well you hold on to that. I'm gonna take out a Gauss hog.
No, it's not.
Oh. No, I mean use it. Park it somewhere and use it from a distance.
Wreck confirmed.
Oh, this round.
Well, this is the night, and then it's the, God. I didn't want a... How to fucking waste then. I didn't want a gunner. Damn it. Because then it's just a waste for me not to be shooting at him also.
Shit.
They're gonna get my fucking thing blown up.
Teammates eliminated a night target. Level 9 wrecks available. Incoming Promethean threat.
The one time I really needed to spawn at the base away from people. That sucked. What are you doing, Sandman?
Shooting banshees.
God, that sucked. That pissed me off so much. Like, I don't need a teammate to be my gunner, because then that just makes me completely useless.
No, wow. One banshee blast from a purple banshee just killed me.
Holy cow, Rafe almost killed me.
Their incinerator.
Don't you dare fucking get in. Just fucking shoot at him, you jackass.
Why is he looking right at me?
Because if he shoots me, I'm gonna die. This guy jumped in front of me, and I would have been so pissed if he was blocking my shots. I mean, I would have been just pissed.
I hear that. Let me go sit in a block of ice.
Ball soup.
Ball swimming in it. Balls soup.
Man, I was having such a hard time earlier, too. Everything works out when nobody gets in my gunner seat.
Man, I kind of enjoyed that. I mean, a couple of rounds.
Just hanging back and shooting from a distance? Yeah, that works out.
Yeah, Noni Hog. Now I know what I can use that ship for.
Yeah, those knights...
Banshees, too.
Those knights don't work. Don't like that. The Needler Hog works great on larger things, knights, banshees, and stuff. Not on soldiers or crawlers. Not at all. I'm gonna buy a gold pack, then I'll buy a silver, and then two bronze.
Those are weak.
Nah, I got lots of my speed boosts. This one was a waste of time. Look at that.
Speed boosts. Swear to God.
I got a beam rifle. A scatter shot, if you could, Sam, and I just stack them on. I got two beam rifles, and that thing, what a load of garbage. That was a gold pack. 4,000 rec points for a bunch of greens and shit. Got a scourge. Oh, and a temple wraith. I have yet to use any of those temple vehicles that I've paid for. Got a talon. Talon of the Lost, one of my favorites. See here, bronze pack. Got a Warzone XP boost. I got two speed boosts. Got a Woodland Scout, which pays for the last one I used in the last game. But a gambit assist for the 30 gambit assists I already have. For Arena, which I never use. Got a carbine. I got
Still
a shotgun.
Stuff, I'm telling you, in the herd.
Oni Mongoose. Where you going, Sandman?
I gotta go to bed. I gotta train some bitches tomorrow.
That's bullshit. Training people. That doesn't exist. You don't need to do that.
Yes, I'm gonna teach them how to drive trains.
tell them not to make any sharp turns on a straight track.
That's day one.
Now, I know you got a steering wheel here, but don't touch it. It kind of drives itself.
Teach them how to wear the uniform, big hat,
the overalls, and then shovel the coal. Oh. It's like, I know all these things are run by electricity now, but still got to shovel that coal. For what?
Still got to show you the basics.
Yeah. Where do you think all the pollution comes from? Electric trains. All right, Zenman. Have a good night.
Actually, run on diesel. I'm out. See you later, y'all.